हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम, स्टे होम। आई होप यू ऑल आर फॉलोइंग गवर्नमेंट रूल्स। सो वी आर गोइंग विद दैट नॉर्म्स टू टीच यू ऑनलाइन द सब्जेक्ट, वन ऑफ योर सब्जेक्ट ऑफ कॉमर्स, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट। दिस इज द इंडेक्स। We are having total 12 chapters. Sorry, we are having total 12 chapters. Number 1 is Nature and Significance of Management, Principles of Management, Planning, Organizing, Staffing, Directing, Controlling, Financial Management, Financial Market, Marketing Management, Consumer Protection, business environment. That's all. So we are going to see today second chapter, which is principles of management. Principles of management. This is not your school's principal or college principal. These are the principles, norms of management. In this chapter, we are going to see meaning of principles of management, concept, nature and importance, thoughts of management, classical thoughts, neoclassical thoughts, in which behavior related thoughts and modern thoughts, Frederick Taylor's principle of scientific management, meaning, definition, principles of scientific management, techniques of principle of scientific management, in which time study, motion study, different wage rate study, Henry Fayol's management principles, contribution of Peter F. Drucker in the field of management. So our first and most important part is introduction. Let me tell you, management activity is carried out since centuries. We all know that in our first chapter we had seen the nature, the characteristics of management. During the rule of Chandragupta Maurya and Chhatrapati Shivaji in India, you can see the proper use of management in war policy. With reconsideration of such concept, management gurus, thinkers have changed new policies, new principles. We are given the name of various gurus in our introduction part. Here, various management gurus from Frederick Taylor to Henry Fayol, Gilbreth, Max Weber, Chester Bernard, Peter F. Drucker and C.K. Pranar played an important role in rendering various principles to make it as per the era. Coons has hailed the ideology of management as general. Let us see the meaning of principles of management. Principles of management plays role of a guide for the managers. Principles of management are not rules, but it is sum, means it is total, and substance means it is matter of assumption, traditions and experiences. Through assumption, we can set our principles. Through traditions, we can continue our principles. And through experiences, we can set our principles. Management gurus have obtained conclusion from such principles. Through such principles, management gurus can obtain conclusion and has been proven practical. In a business unit, some rules, principles might be formed in relation to the human behavior. So, the achievement of goal becomes easy. These principles are called as the principles of the management. Okay, so we know that all the rules, principles are formed for human behavior so that we can easily achieve our goals. And these principles are called as the principles of the management. The second point is concept. Management is a combination of an art and science. As a science, it has principles. But principles of management are not as rigid as the pure science. They are flexible in this case. Now you will be asked one question from here, one statement from here. Why principles of management are not as rigid as the pure science? Explain. So the answer is, principles of management have direct relationship with human behavior. We can change which is required and can add new principles. Again, principle of management have direct relationship with human behavior. We can change which is required and can add new principles. Human behavior and technology are such factors which changes periodically. The changes take place in the principles of management to cope up. The changes take place in the principles of management to cope up with the new changes. The change which is required, human behavior can be changed, technology can be changed. That is why management, principles of management are not as rigid as science. Principles of management are the detailed and perfect guideline for the decision making and its implementation. As per the principle of management, the capability of employee could be increased. Again, as per the principle of management, the capability of employee could be increased. How? By encouragements. For example, to consider his service years to make decision about promotion of any employee. While employee gets promotion by considering his capability in other unit. Okay, so as per the principle of management, the capability of employee could be increased through encouragements, and by considering his service years, we can make decision about his promotion. It is important to understand the difference between principles of management and techniques of management. Okay, so we are given difference between principles of management and techniques of management. Let's see. Techniques of management. Techniques are set of steps taken to achieve target. Okay, so techniques are the steps to achieve target. While principles of management are the guidelines for the decision which have been taken during implementation of the techniques. While we are implementing the techniques, the guideline which is to be used for decision taking is known as principles of management. The another difference is given between principles and values like techniques. Principles are universal truth and guidelines for human behavior, while techniques are acceptable or preferable. So the next and the third point is nature of principles of management. As we all know, principles of management are not rigid but practical. Conclusion. These principles are the guidelines to perform a task. As per expert opinion, mostly these principles are truth but are not absolute truth. So here we are having some exceptional case also. Not all the time, all the principles can work. As per our board discussions regarding the principles of management, we can conclude following points. The first point is universal acceptance. First, understand the point. Universal acceptance. Universal means overall. Let's see. Principles of management can be applied to most of the business units. Okay. Where can be applied? Number one is most of the business units. Wherever there is a need of human collective efforts. Okay. So we can remember first is business unit and the second is human collective efforts. These principles are required at business units, all the business units and human collective efforts. However, implementation of all the principles may change as per the type, form, activity and size of the business unit. So every business unit has its different type. So this acceptance is also can be different. So the implementation of all the principles can be changed as per the type of business unit, form of business unit, activity of business unit and size of the business unit. For example, a large unit or large companies needs to be different from small scale industry. So the large scale industry has different principles of management and small scale industry has different type of principles of management. It can be changed as per the type, form, activity and size of the business unit. But it is overall acceptable. The second point is flexible. Flexible means which can be changed as per the time period. Principles of management are not rigid conclusion, but it is flexible. As per situation, when a manager requires, there is a scope for flexibility. When these principles do not seem to match in some situation, the manager is allowed to effect change. For example, let me give you one example. In Henry Fayol's principles, one of management principles says unity of command, which says employees cannot follow orders from more than one superior. But sometimes in some critical situation, they have to follow instruction from two superior. The third point is general guidelines. Principles of management are the result of experiences gained by different experts in different situations. As we all know, in the meaning of principles of management, we have seen principles of management is only the sum and substance of the assumptions, traditions and experiences. So here, the principles of management are the result of experts, experiences from experts. At the time of managing a business unit, disparate and complex problems are arising. The form of these issues may be different as per the unit, which could not be give similar result for each unit in all the situation. So it cannot provide same result for every unit. So sometimes the issues may be different, the result also may be different. The principles of management could not be strictly applied for each unit, but you can get desired results by accepting the principles as only guidelines and by using it in favorable situation. So not in all the situation the principles of management are strictly applied, but at least we can get desired results, guidelines, by using it in favorable situation. The next is based on human behavior. As we all know that principles of management are directly connected with human behavior. As human is at the center of the management, the principles of management may seem to have a big effect on human behavior. Principle of management has direct relationship with the human behavior, and as the human behavior is a psychological phenomenon, it is necessary to consider while implementing principles of management. We can see all the principles which are formed for human being, considers division of work, authority and responsibility, unity of command, unity of direction, order, equality, and so on. They all are connected with human behavior only. So it is totally based on human behavior. The next is contingency. Contingency is one of the elements to apply the principles of management. Contingencies means contingent situation, which is unavoidable situation or uncertain situation with which we are not aware about. So with principles of management we can get out of it, we can get guidelines from that, and we can cover or recover our situation. Achievement of goal can be made easier by a unit with taking required decision through usage of these principles in certain unavoidable situation, such as to pay appropriate and reasonable wages to the employees. Now, for example, in this time of Corona, too many companies or management kick their employees from their work because companies are not having enough amount of profit to provide them. So in such a critical contingent situation, company has to take decision and company needs guidelines, and that guidelines will be provided from principles of management. Company can get proper decision and guideline from the principles of management. This criteria of being fair and reasonable depends upon the concern regarding necessity and contingency of the affecting factor. So that's all for the today's session. We had seen principles of management introduction, meaning, concept, and nature. Again repeating, in nature, universal acceptance, flexible, general guidelines based on human behavior, and contingencies. I hope you all understand the concept, the main introduction and meaning of principles of management along with nature. In our next session, we are going to see importance of principles of management. Till then, stay home, stay safe.
Thank you for watching this video.